Automobile tires are made of rubber to provide sufficient grip on the road. Automobiles are light in weight, so vehicles do need more coefficient of friction for a good traction. But in case of railroads, these are very shiny and slippery. Since locomotives have enough weight on wheels, these do not need maximum area of contact with the rail tracks. If train wheels were made of rubber, it would have been impossible to pull the cargo. So metal wheels with minimum area of contact with tracks are fitted. But the next doubt arises is that if the area of contact is very less and wheels are shiny and slippery, then why doesn't a train skid on the tracks? Locomotives pull thousands of tons of cargo weight. A single engine in front of freight moves the whole train without losing traction on railroad. It is achieved by a device fitted inside the loco engine called the wheel slip protection. When loco starts acceleration, if slip is observed, speed is reduced, and this is how a good adhesion is made between track and wheels. One more thing that helps to eliminate slip is that the complete train is not a chunk of mass. It is divided into pieces, and all pieces together are connected with a slackness. This slackness helps loco to pull a bogie just next to it. When loco starts acceleration, it only pulls the bogie next to it, breaking its static friction. Then the first bogie after the loco pulls the second bogie, and so the complete train accelerates. You may have seen these type of separators are used in passenger coaches. When trains gain sufficient speed, these separators comes out so that when train deaccelerates, coaches do not bang into each other. When wheel slip protection devices were not there, loco engines were fitted with these sanding equipments. Sand was poured on the rail tracks whenever slip occurs during deacceleration or acceleration.